Hello, today I will give you information on ELISA test used in the clinical laboratory to diagnose specific diseases. Full form of ELISA is enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. It is also known as enzyme immunoassay or EIA. It is a test that detects and measures specific antibodies in serum or blood of a patient produced in response to a specific antigen. The antibodies are IgM type, which is produced as a response to an antigen like a virus or a bacteria during first week of the infection, and IgG produced as late response to an infection, mostly after 2 weeks. You have already learned various tests which measure blood components present in terms of grams, milligrams and micrograms. However, this test is able to detect nanomolecules such as antibodies, and remember, 1000 nanograms are equal to 1 microgram. ELISA tests are used as a screening test or as qualitative and quantitative test to diagnose various diseases caused by viruses and bacteria such as COVID-19, other flu viruses, HIV, dengue fever, chikungunya, hepatitis viruses, etc. Today I will give you information on screening test for COVID-19. The ELISA screening kit contains a test card in a sealed pouch and disposable heparinized capillaries, buffer solution and one user manual. Working of this kit is based on ELISA-Immunochromatography principle, which I have explained after the test procedure. Test procedure is as follows. First, 10 microliter of patient's blood is collected by finger prick using a blood capillary. Fasting is not necessary. Then, in the second step, 10 microliter of blood is added in the test well as shown in the figure. In the third step, 3 drops of buffer solution is added to buffer well as shown in the figure. And in the fourth stage, after 15 minutes, test card or strip is observed for test results. Well, this observation indicates corona test is positive. This observation indicates that corona test is negative. And by chance, if you get this observation, then test is invalid and should be repeated by using a new test card. Now I will explain you the composition of basic part of the test card. It is composed of 5 different distinct parts made up of nitrocellulose membrane. One is sample application pad, and it is made up of multi-layered nitrocellulose membrane. When blood or serum is added here, all the components of the sample pass and migrate in a smooth flow according to the chromatography principle. The components move according to their various sizes. That means smaller molecules will pass at faster rate and bigger molecules will pass in a slow manner in capillary action. And blood cells and other interfering substances, because of their large sizes, will not pass due to the sieving action of the nitrocellulose membrane. It is shown in the figure here. On the second part of the pad, labeled antigen protein, that means N and S protein of COVID virus is attached, and these are coated with colloidal micro gold particles. The property of colloidal gold particles is that they bind specifically with the specific antibodies forming hydrogen bonds, and the aggregated particles can be seen visibly. In the third part on the line, a matching antibody is usually applied over the surface so that it can bind to the antigen, and this antibody is linked to an enzyme, and this antibody is anti-human IgG and the enzyme is peroxidase. And in the fourth part, anti-human IgG antibody is coated. In the final step, enzyme substrate is added, and usually the substrate is hydrogen peroxide, also contains one chromosome, tetramethylbenzidine, and the subsequent reaction produces a detectable color change in the form of color bands. Well, after the blood sample or serum sample has been applied to the test strip, the gold label recombinant N protein or S protein will combine with COVID IgM or IgG antibody respectively in sample and form marked antigen antibody complexes. These complexes move to the test card detection zone by capillary action, and then marked antigen antibody complexes will be captured on different test lines by anti-human IgM and IgG antibodies. When buffer is added, it contains substrate hydrogen peroxide for peroxidase enzyme and linked to anti-IgM or anti-IgG. Peroxidase acts on hydrogen peroxide and releases oxygen, which reacts with chromogen tetramethylbenzidine, resulting in purplish red bands on the test lines.